In today's video, we will see that what made Einstein get his Nobel Prize. In the year 1887, Hertz conducted an experiment in which he connected a metal to the negative terminal of the battery, while a detector was connected to the positive terminal. The whole system was placed in a vacuum so that no conduction, that is, no electricity could pass. Then he radiated the metal surface with a light source and connected an ammeter in the circuit. When the light source was switched on, it was found that ammeter showed a deflection, and this was clearly because of the light source. So here something interesting was found out, that in presence of light, some metals like potassium, rubidium, cesium conducts electricity. And this whole effect was known as photoelectric effect. He then observed certain things in this effect. That is, there was no time lag between the radiation or the striking of light on the metal surface and ejection of electron. The number of electrons ejected was directly proportional to the brightness of light. And there was a characteristic frequency, that is the threshold frequency, below which the photoelectric effect could not be observed. Now this was something strange, as till date we saw light as a wave, and now a wave is taking out an electron from a metal. So this made scientists curious. Also, as per wave nature, the intensity of light is directly proportional to the number and energy of electrons. That is, brighter the light, more the energy of electrons would be. But on the contrary, it was found out that kinetic energy of electron was independent of brightness. For example, a potassium surface could be radiated via red light for hours and no photoelectrons could be ejected. But in presence of very feeble yellow light, photoelectric effect occurred. This indicated that kinetic energy dependent upon frequency of the radiation. Now the scientists were confused. See, experimentally Hertz did the photoelectric effect, but to explain photoelectric effect, wave theory was incapable. And then came the savior, Albert Einstein. He used Max Planck's theory of electromagnetic radiation to explain the photoelectric effect. And because of his explanation, he got the Nobel Prize. He said to see the light as a beam of particles and called each particle as photon. The energy of each photon was given by E is equals to h nu, which was given by Max Planck. He used the same formula. He said photoelectric effect could occur only when the energy of photon is greater than the threshold frequency. He said that intensity of EM radiation could be seen as quantity of photon. More the quantity, the brighter the light is, that is intense the light is. But for photoelectric effect to occur, the quantity does not matter. Until and unless the photon has the quality of that threshold frequency or the quality of energy that is greater than the threshold energy, until and unless it does not have that, the photoelectric effect won't occur. He said, whenever a photon strikes at the metal, it transfers energy to the electron and electron gains that energy and that is converted into the kinetic energy. That is, higher the energy of photon, more will be the transfer and the higher the energy of electron would be. He said that kinetic energy is equals to h nu minus h nu naught, where h nu naught was called as the work function. As you can see here, in a nutshell, it could be said that h nu is equals to work function plus kinetic energy.